La avaricia financiera de la familia Turpin. David Turpin had been a well-paid engineer but after he left his job they started to run out of money, Mr. Lambert told the Sunday People. He claimed the perils about their financial fortunes and living in a huge house. After a family member died, Mrs. Turpin called her brother to check on any possible inheritance, he revealed. Mr. Lambert said, "Se calle to see if the staff had been sorted so se would get some money. For the last 7 years, they carried on the pretense that David was working with it was all a sham. The Turpins claimed to be living in a 7-bedroom home rather than the modest bungalow where the children were allegedly found chained by police. These money problems are aside to part of the reason the mother of 13 was so determined to have yet another child as a maintained fantasies of becoming rich from television rights. The family even moved to California to be closer to Hollywood hoping to mirror the career of US television star Kat Plus 8, Mr. Lambert claims. Aside, they thought it would make them millions and also names. They didn't care about the kids, it was all about them. Mr. Lambert said they will never speak to his sister again but hopes to adopt the 3 youngest children and help care for them as they are useless and blow up. His sister Teresa also hopes to adopt some of the siblings. David Allen Turpin, 57, and Louisiana Turpin, 49, are facing life in prison over charges including torture and child endangerment. The arrests were made after one of the 13 siblings called police and said their 12 brothers and sisters were being held captive, with the siblings, a headboat of 29, found severely malnourished in a filthy house of horrors. The children were chained up, beaten and starved as punishment for doing something as simple as washing their hands above their wrists. According to police. In further claims, the parents even left out toys they could not play with and food they could not eat to taunt the children.